Everybody, welcome over. Oh, are we excited about what we have to show you. So, there's been, well, let me just introduce first. Brandon here first, technical architect. Gregor's enterprise technical architect, known as G.
Hi, how are you doing, guys?
You guys have to forgive things. I'm from Oklahoma.
I'm from Poland.
When you get two people, you know, like that together, you know, it's just going to get all kinds of unprofessional. So anyway, here's the deal. How fast is Dynamics 365 on-premise? You're probably wondering, just how much does it handle performance, right? Well, I'm here to tell you, got some great news. Gregor's and I put it through the test, and we installed it, and we're going to run the most intuitive test that you can possibly run, right? We call it the user test. You know, right after you finish installing, how the first day, you know, and it's something that I can tell you right now, every technical architect fears, because you never know how it's going to go, no matter how much testing you do. The user clicks and starts clicking through the forms. Ordinarily, on demo environments, this is horrible. So what we're going to do is we're going to take an on-premise environment with the sample demo data, and we're going to do some timings for form loadings and compare them so that you can get a realistic image of what we got. Now, Gregor's will start out. He's going to explain some things to you. He's going to show you some really cool things. I think you guys will love it a lot. Bam.
Thank you. Functional environment with a high speed, I would say. I should say.
You know it. So for everyone who's been saying that it costs buku super money.
It's not. Yeah. Okay. So what we use? We use one host. We use hypervisor. And what we have here? We have 32 logical processor, 16 cores. We've got 192 gig of RAM. Okay, we have only 6 no rated hard drives. Okay, what else? We use Hyper-V as our hypervisor, and we use Royal TS to connect to our remotely to all our machines. Okay, what we have on the hypervisor, and we can see on the Royal TS as well. We've got one domain controller, one ADFS, and to be honest, we are thinking to maybe collapse and put both together so we can reduce even more. We've got SQL cluster, so always on, so have two servers. Then we've got 3 orchestra servers, and rest of them are AOSs.
You know it, right? And if you guys take a look, notice right now on our machines how many we've actually cut down from the standard recommended part. Let's see just for a second if we can bring it up again. Right over here, notice that we've only got 7 nodes. Now, wait a minute. 7 nodes. That's it.
Is that even possible? Yes, it is.
Oh, apparently it is, isn't it? As you guys are about to find out. 2 AOSs, 1 management reporter, 3 orchestrators, and 1 report server. Furthermore, and I'll let Gregor's walk through this, take a look at the specs on the RAM that we've dedicated to each and every single processor if you take a look through Hyper-V. Take a look at the RAM and the processors that we've put on. So for our AOSs, AX on-prem, you guys can see over here 6 and 7. Let's go to 6 for just a moment and see how much we've put on.
Okay, so we can see here we've got a 12 gig of RAM assigned to the number 6. Number 7, 12 gig of RAM.
12 gigs of RAM assigned to the AOS is it. Plus management reporter.
On top of that, we virtualize our SQL cluster. So it's no physical server, it's both nodes are only virtual. And that's it. You can see the domain controller got 16 gig, we've got ADFS 16 gig, and we've got both SQL server 16 gig each.
Yep, and then for our ADFS proxy, we just put that straight on the host. Yeah. It's not even running on this. It's straight on the host. Take a look at this. Just so you guys can see over here, we actually took it and we put it straight on the host.
Is that no something? We try to run against any.
Speaking of that, you know what? We better watch out for the hackers, though. Once you get on DNS, the hackers come. So what we do is we run this little cheap script to download off the internet, and it basically will take all the little hackers, you know, and go ahead and quickly, you know, basically put them on the little blacklist of the firewall. I'm not saying this is an enterprise type thing to be able to do, but in our cloud, for us who didn't have time to go ahead and put back expensive hardware and some super firewalls, this was temporarily a great solution for a lab environment.
And let me show you something else. Aside from the very little of RAM, 16 gig, we also give not that many of processors. Okay, SQL, two processors, Orchestral. Two processors, and I show you we've got for all the orchestras the same. No, it's one, it's two processors. Then AOSs. How many? Probably the same, two processors. You know, the price for all of that is, some people think is a lot. No, we figure out we can close this price in around $262 a month, which is you know, I think for this kind of environment is a good price, and we have fully functional environment.
You guys see that too, and look at that. I mean, we could have taken it up on processors. Now remember, some of you might be in there. If you had AOS even inside of a sandbox environment and you gave it two processors to run SQL, you're gonna see all kinds of slowness. So everyone remember and please watch that. Two processors, 16 gigs of RAM given to SQL, two processors, 12 gigs given to the AOS. You've gotta be wondering, is this thing even gonna run? Like I said, when I said we gave it the user test, we gave it the user test. Woo, so you guys have just seen an example of where we took a minimum environment. And don't get me wrong, for performance tuning, I used to often stress test AX2012s and 2009s against minimum environments. So we figured, why not start with the least? And you see, even on our machine, we haven't even used all the RAM or the processors yet. We haven't done anything like that. Now, the one thing we did do was we did use some human interference to go ahead and make Service Fabric run faster than Microsoft's guidelines. So there were some tricks applied, but they were all on the software level, not on the hardware level. Very important to get down. So in the next series, let's take a look at the cluster. Okay, so now everyone has seen the test, or everyone's seen the scenario, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a click-through test over here with these minimum resources, and by the way, everyone got to go on. Everyone could see AX on-prem 3. Only 7 nodes, not 3 AOSs, just 2. Everyone can see that. 1 report server, 1 management server. Everyone can see a confirmed deployment for on-prem. So this is a working on-prem instance, D365. So our evidence is all there. Now what we're going to do, going back to one of our AOSs, we're going to go ahead and do a click test to see what kind of speed we get. If it's like 2012, going with this sort of memory should be horrible performance, or if it's like what we've seen in other places too.
So usually I will go to do the tea or coffee, and Brandon will click between the forums.
Yep.
Uh-huh. This time I didn't have even time to stand from my seat. Okay.
Woo! All right, let's see the results here going by human hand. Ready? I'm going to click play first. We're going to do a classic thing where we click from the list page onto some things. And first of all, here's an environment. Let's turn it over from DAT to USMF and Contoso. La la la, USMF usually is a pretty nice size one. Good one for doing some minor beginning type assessments. Put it this way, users will oftentimes notice things wrong with USMF whenever there's a beginning hardware issue. Now remember, you've seen the hardware. We did make some software changes that are great for later tutorials. There are ways to be able to optimize Service Fabric, and we did do that, but we did not touch the AOS code or anything else. We just strictly used architecture stuff for being able to optimize some rules within Service Fabric. Okay, here we go. So it comes to test. Let's go ahead and do an interesting comparison for everyone to see. I'm gonna make this just a little bit smaller. Here's a stopwatch. I'm gonna click play, so it's gonna have a 1 second lead. Here we go, go. Boom! Oh, minus 1 second, that was 2.5 seconds. What AOS did this in 2.5 seconds? Okay, let's see another one. Here we go again. And remember, we only did configuration on Service Fabric, that was it. Way less hardware than recommended, and it is smoking. Ready for this? Open customer invoices. Boom! Another 2 seconds. It took me 2 seconds just to move over. Gregors, oh man, I think people are gonna have to stop taking breaks. This thing is so much faster. Does everybody see this? Okay.
It's not much fun anymore.
I know, I'm telling you, man, we're gonna be out of work if this keeps up. Once people learn a few little tricks. Uh-oh, whoops, let me hit this over here. I clicked off of it. But go back to it right there. There we go. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and try another one that used to call.
Just put some stress on the server because.
I know, I'm telling you, look at this. It's running with way less. This is incredible. All right, let's try another one. Let's try, oh, here we go, ready? Let's try.
Purchase order confirmation.
Whoops, my son's little daycare, sorry. Boom! Another second, it takes me 2 seconds to move it over, 1 second to get it. Guys, it is smoking.
It was
smoking.
I was very surprised when we see that, the effect on the sound box. It's just incredible.
Can I please take you on-premise over to my AX2012 implementations that I'm performance tuning? Please, please, please. I'd be the hero. We'd all be the heroes. So, okay, in summary, guys, let's talk about this just for a second. Hang on 1 sec, and me and Gregor will come on the camera.
So it looked fast. I didn't grow the beard during the implementation of that or during setup. That was much before, and I thought I can always say, it's another implementation with the long beard they call.
Yeah, no, right?
See, it's just excellent.
Way better than 2012. In fact, I haven't had any results like this in the cloud, and I've worked plenty of cloud implementations. I'm not knocking the cloud. I'm just saying I have, and what I'm guessing is it's probably because of the loss of latency and the ability to be able to performance tune some of the service fabric settings, you know. We're saving that for future tutorials. We got an upcoming course that we're going to be teaching, by the way, on-prem. And we promise you there's nothing like it where we're going to go. We're talking about some fast implementations. Guys, from an architecture perspective, it's been a long time since I've seen an AX really run like this. But just overall, you can see the improvements. And when you knock out the latency, really, that seems to be the biggest issue with our performance. But when you knock out the latency like we just did, it just hands down whips the previous version of AX. Can it handle an enterprise load?
For sure, Tom.
No, for sure. Guys, till later on, part two, we'll be talking about some special things you can do to make things work. Don't want to miss it. Been a lot of fun with you guys.
Thank you very much.
Woo! Bam!